Thank you, Chair. I think it isn't business as usual because the Vice President of the Commission has achieved one thing that is pretty revolutionary, and that is that the work programme has indeed been kept confidential until today. So that is a real achievement for which I congratulate you. So I haven't really had time to read it in great detail, but going through it, I note a lot of very positive things for which you will get the support of my group. That is indeed in the chapter on migration and asylum, a border and coast guard proposal, a proposal to revitalize the blue card. I also note the proposal on a work-life balance. I suppose that's new Eurospeak for maternity leave, or it will indeed at least be in there. I also note a proposal for the external representation of the euro, the common currency. So that we all welcome, and I'm sure there is a lot more in there that you will get our support for. There are also a couple of things missing, I think, and a couple of question marks. One of the things that I would like to see in there, and it has been requested by this House, is when we're talking about the security and counterterrorism chapter, we urgently, for many years now, need a thorough, detailed evaluation of the measures that are in place already and their effectiveness. And that, I think, is really part of better lawmaking. Then, I don't know if it's in there, a reference to somehow unblocking the horizontal anti-discrimination directive and unblocking the transparency regulation. I'll come back to that. Then, of course, something that this House has been calling for, and I will have the honour and pleasure, I'm sure, to elaborate, is a mechanism for the enforcement of fundamental rights, the rule of law and democratic governance. And then finally, in this list, on the digital agenda, I very much welcome your words, but I wonder how I then should interpret the words of Mr. Oettinger that instead of creating an open worldwide web, we're going to put a fence around the European cloud and the European internet, and I hope that you are not sharing his views. One final remark, because we're talking a lot here about political topics, but better lawmaking, in my view, is not about the outcome of political debates, it's about the process itself. And there I think the Commission should and could do a lot more. I already mentioned transparency. I mean, there we really need to make some leaps forward, because we're still in the era of diplomats and civil servants meeting behind closed doors. We also need to look at enforcement. I only need to mention Safe Harbour and Dieselgate. We also need to look at the quality of legislation, because, and then we need to also look at ourselves in a more critical manner. I'm pretty sick and tired of passing legislation that we know is legally unsound and will end up before the European Court of Justice sooner or later. So there is a whole lot more that can be said about the process, but I would like to see more emphasis on the process, because the final outcome, that's a matter of political choice, political preference. There are no objective criteria. But how we manage the process, that is something that we can all share. Thank you.
Thank you.